already.
I'm like, yeah.
Yeah.
Howdy, everybody. Are we ready now? Howdy. What about now? Ranger?
Anna.
That one. She hasn't been on here in a while. That's Karla.
Yes.
Cherie.
Holland.
Space cat.
Space cat.
And Mama. She's all the way over there. Then. Hi, Mama.
I'm not here, Junebug.
Junebug's down the floor.
Junebug's down the floor. She'll be up and down. I don't know. But, anyhow. Appreciate y'all stopping by for our little Christmas special. I forgot I was going to do this for Monday, but I thought, now I'll save it for Christmas. This is our big Christmas extravaganza.
Yeah. Christmas tree.
And so, in case you haven't noticed, there's three bottles of soda. Now, those are Mexican sodas, so we're going to be taste testing those.
Will they speak Spanish when we burp?
Yeah. Yeah, they fizz in Spanish.
Will we burp? Spanish?
Yeah, probably.
Actually, Fanta, I have heard, is Nazi pop.
Yeah.
Or Juju.
That was then. Well, it's like Volkswagen.
Yeah.
Volkswagen. I'm guessing that box is from Switzerland.
Yeah. Oh, give it away.
Well, hold on. It says that the mountains are alive.
You forgot to introduce Junebug.
And it has a little...
No, it didn't.
Oh, there she is.
There she is.
Yeah, Boobug.
Yeah. But, anyhow, if y'all are at home this Christmas Day or stuck at an airport or one of our service people out
stuck in snow
mm-hmm. or service people in the military or stuck somewhere watching this, Merry Christmas.
Feliz Navidad.
I don't know any of the other ones, something. Anyway, happy Christmas. Happy holidays.
There's Kwanzaa, Hanukkah.
Yeah, those are different days. This is Christmas Day.
Oh, Christmas Day. Oh, yeah, okay. I thought we were talking about, like, holiday.
Holiday.
Like, all the holidays in December.
Anywho, here's the hint.
A place
the hills are alive.
Where the hills are alive.
North and Dakota.
And it has a picture of the thing singing.
And then there's a picture, yeah.
North Dakota.
Hills are alive with the sound of
Michigan.
Music.
Music.
Throughout this video, we're going to have some awesome music by Aaron Baxter. His wife with Aaron. He's been doing some really cool Christmas covers, so we're going to be...
Yes.
We can't hear it because I had that on the post-production, but he's going to be entertaining you guys in the background.
Yeah.
Anyhow, here we go. I'd say Switzerland. Mm-hmm. Of course, y'all know what it's going to be because it's going to be in the title.
Colorado.
Colorado.
They're singing.
Rocky Mountain. What are the things called?
No, that's a different one.
What are the things called that they like yodel and didgeridoo-looking things on the mountains?
Horn, yeah. They call them some kind of horn.
I mean, it's not didgeridoo, but it looks like them. But it's big. It does have the mountains are singing in my woods.
Yeah, the hills
are singing.
Ricola!
Yeah, the Ricola guy! Yeah!
Ricola! Yeah, whatever they call those horns.
Time for a cough drop!
I feel like I'm in one.
Right now.
Wait, this is a commercial, honey.
Huh?
What?
Yeah.
The horn? I mean, there's a circle at the end of it so that the sound comes out. Okay. And it's
Colorado.
Austria. I've been there. I have been there.
Okay.
You've been there.
I've been to Austria.
There are people out there that are like, idiot.
What?
Sounds of Music was in Austria, not Switzerland.
Was it?
Did they
screw it? This is really key. It's got a deer skin. Idaho.
Oh, and guess
it's
what?
It's actually, yeah, it was in Austria.
And guess what? Austria speaks
German. Ooh. Anybody know German?
just the mask.
But their German is apparently really weird. So
plus, they got games on the back.
Yeah, because I wasn't here for the actual
we
German.
Just have, we don't have time to do all the games and all the cool stuff. But, and this time, because the last time I had it, I'm going to make sure it's lit up.
Are you blind?
Salzburg, that's where I went. I saw where Mozart was born. Oh, that's cool.
Spring in this bar.
Spring.
Put the fall back in it.
I'm sorry, one liner. Are we doing the trivia or not? Because.
I always try to stick it. Blown over. Make sure it's not upside down. When I was editing, I was like, oh no.
You know, when it takes the video, it'll be upside down, so you can put it upside down. That's so it'll be right side down.
You can't do that because it would be upside down.
No,
and the rest of our brains would fall out.
Oh, okay, are we doing this?
We're doing trivia.
Okay, cool.
Trivia, yes. Alex, for $1,000.
For $1,000, Alex. Okay, Austria is home to the world's oldest A, zoo, B, ski lodge, C, restaurant, or D, salt mine.
Ski lodge?
I want to say ski lodge.
B.
Yeah, because they like their skiing. Yeah.
So it is
be salt mine.
A, C, and D.
All of them.
Yeah, so, the one that
and you're a winner, and you're a winner, you're a winner.
It's carved out with religious figures and stuff.
And you get $1,000, and you get $1,000.
If there is one thing Austria has tons of, it's old stuff. Yeah. Vienna, you'll find the world's oldest operating zoo, Tiergarten Schönbrunn, opened since 1752. Then you can take a train to Salzburg and visit St. Peter Stützkeller, the world's oldest restaurant. I might have been there.
Ooh. Let's talk to you. Ooh, but it's important.
I don't remember, but the world's oldest restaurant, Christopher Columbus and Mozart have been there. And then you can go to Hallein to see the world's oldest salt mine, Hallstatt, which has been a primary salt source for over 7,000 years. Okay.
Well, speaking of Austria, he's there in Austria, but he's close by. Monica Biss, he's in Germany, visiting his girlfriend. If you're watching,
hey, Mama! Good God!
Okay. Mama!
Also, Glocks are made there. So if you like nuns, they're made in Austria.
Yep.
Pew pew! Pew pew! Okay. The pew pews are made there. Okay, so number two. At Starkenberger Castle, visitors can A, bathe in hot beer, B, eat $300 strudel, C, sleep on swan feathers, or D, slow dance with dolls. I think the strudel. I'm gonna say the $300 strudel.
I say bathe in the beer.
I did not go to that castle.
Feathers.
Bathe in hot. I bet it's bathe in hot beer.
Bathe in hot beer.
Yeah, my guess.
I'll second that.
Okay. I can do this. You can bathe in hot beer. So
if you get $1,000,
let's see. So the Starkenberger is a brewery castle where visitors can kick back and relax in baths of warm beer. The seven baths are filled with a mixture of hot water and beer, 80 gallons worth, which is said to have a healing effect on skin.
Let me go swimming in it, honey.
I bet it's more than $300.
I bet. All right.
I think I'll pass.
Three.
Smell
like
kind of weird.
It probably smells like
there's
free.
For free?
Some kind of
what would be free?
Or something where you wash your hair in beer.
Yeah.
It's supposed to do something.
My sister used to do that.
Yeah,
let's go get some Bud Light and do a hair soak.
Yeah. I told Karla they could pee in it. You'd never know.
That beer tastes weird. I mean, the bubble bath tastes weird.
You know that people would think it's the greatest thing in the world. You know it. If you peed in it and called it beer, people would love it.
You know it.
People are crazy.
Just get the Kardashians to say,
I can't hear about it.
Buy this.
I wash my hair and pee.
Pee beer.
You know,
and my hair's so luscious. Lord. Not to say that I don't have extensions.
I don't right?
If you want to grow going. Hair, wash your hair.
And pee. Yeah. Somebody out there will try that.
Hey, yeah. Like the ammonia might cleanse.
Yeah,
cleanse your hair.
It'll have a pretty yellow shampoo.
Kim Kardashian shampoo. If you use her shampoo, you're in for beautiful hair. Get it? You're in.
Yeah, you're in.
Hair.
You're in.
The Kardashians would love us. Yeah. Now we're not talking about them real famous Kardashians. We're talking about the other family.
The other one. Okay.
All right. Let's.
All right. Number three. Approximately 99% of Austrians, A, know how to ski. B, regularly recycle. C, know how to waltz. Or D, vote in elections.
Know how to waltz.
All of the above.
I would say at least regularly recycle.
I'd say all of them.
I think they're recycling.
Learn how to ski.
They recycle.
Yeah.
I got it.
Yeah. They take the time. Well, Germany is the same way.
I'd say they learn to ski when they're babies.
They're skiing, recycling.
In total, locals recycle 54% of their total household waste. They are the second leading recycler on Earth, right behind Germany.
Ooh. Germany.
Ooh.
They recycle everything.
Seriously, in Germany, you have these different colored bins
for
each certain thing, and like on a different day, they come get it. I'm pretty sure it's like
man, can you imagine how many bins you'd have if we had to do that?
Yeah,
and if you've been drinking a bunch of beer and stuff in like glass bottles, all you have to do is set it out, and it helps the homeless because they'll come collect it and then. Get 10 cents.
You know,
so
we should start doing that and help the homeless and the veterans that are homeless also.
That's right.
Yeah.
Thank you, veterans.
All right.
All of y'all.
Number four, in rural Austria, women once courted men by giving them. Oh Lord, here we go.
A black eye.
A tear-stained handkerchief. A jar of pickled eggs. Sweaty apple slices.
A hanky.
Or a pair of dirty socks. I'm feeling the dirty socks.
Yeah, dirty socks.
I'm feeling the eggs.
Hey, sounds like a country song. Tear stained handkerchief.
That sounds like Hank Williams.
My tear stained handkerchief. I know my baby loves me.
About the eggs?
She sent me a tear stained
It's the sweaty apple slices.
Ew.
Is it sweaty like condensation? So I'll find it.
Yeah, read on.
Hold on. Back in the 19th century, if a rural Austrian woman wanted to court a man, she'd have to wait until a community dance. Then she'd place an apple slice in her armpit, waltz the night away, and when the time was right, present the sweaty apple to her gentleman of choice.
Oh,
he was interested. He'd take a bite.
That's got to be real love.
That is one punching apple.
Yeah.
I'd say that was a ripe apple.
Yeah, it was real ripe.
That's where the apple of my eye comes in.
That is disgusting.
I cannot unsee that. A woman sticking big apple chunks. Here, I want to date that.
Okay.
Honey.
I don't know.
That's back when they didn't bathe real well either.
Oh, God.
Okay. Five. In the town of Herrenbaumgarten, you can find a museum of A, stuffed animals, B, food waste, C, broken toys, or D, failed inventions.
Failed
waste. I want to say failed inventions.
I would say failed food inventions. Waste, because they've been picking all the worst.
I did broken toys.
Boy.
It's failed inventions.
So,
I'm on a roll
today.
It's the Austria's Museum of Nonsense Inventions. The idea originated when a group followed bars.
Nincompoops.
In 1984, it attracted over five times the town's population. By 1994, they accumulated enough useless objects to open a museum. One of the exhibitions is a shoe with a tube of lipstick as a heel. And a travel case made of spaghetti.
Major
that actually sounds pretty awesome. Yeah.
A travel case
made of spaghetti.
Well, I guess you got
to
get
it.
You've seen it.
I reckon it was. Six. The
probably you don't get wet in water. You get noodles.
All right. The subway system in the village of Surfaus is the A, longest, shortest, fastest, or slowest in the world.
Fastest.
I bet that's the one that No, what is the subway?
It's a subway system that's long, short, fast, or slow.
Fast.
I'll say fastest.
Especially if they have the
snow. Subway goes 300 miles an hour.
It's the shortest.
Oh. It's probably about a quarter mile long.
Okay, the village's tiny subway, the Dorfbahn Surfbus, serves only one purpose, transporting skiers. Home to the world-renowned alpine skiers are Surfbus Fislatis. The village of Surfbus installed a single-line subway to transport up to 270 skiers from massive car park to the slopes in just 7 minutes. Bonus fact, the Dorfbahn is also the highest subway in the world.
Alright.
Okay. So, number 7. Which of the following was accidentally invented in Austria?
Gilbert?
A. Yeah, right. A. A snow globe.
Apple Senator.
B.
Wrong deodorant.
Yeah, Apple Senator.
Apple Senator. Which, I mean, I wouldn't be mad about it, but... A, a snow globe, B, wind chimes, C, a bird feeder, or D, jack in the box. I don't like jack in the box.
Jack in the box.
Okay. So, it is snow globe. So, in the late 19th century, surgical instruments manufacturer named Erwin Prentze was working on a new surgical lamp. As he tinkered with a fluid-filled bulb used to focus light, he noticed the particles inside looked like snow, so he ran with it, patenting his snow globe under the name Schneekugel and opening a specialty shop.
I like Schneekugel.
No, Schnee means snow.
Schnee.
I don't know what a kugel is, but it's a Schneekugel. Well, I guess
it's globe. Like hula hoops.
Kugel, I guess, is globe.
3 years they just had a hoop and they would run with it. But then one day somebody stopped and said, wait a minute, I'm going to quit running. And they.
Do my
what was that? Did you know slinkies? Slinkies were invented on accident.
Oh yeah, there's a lot of.
We need to do a show called "What Was Invented Accidentally."
Yeah, serendipitously they were invented.
Apple deodorant.
Yeah, y'all need to create.
Like silly putty. Silly putty was just for kids.
Yeah,
but he took that failure and said, "You know what? I want to put this on a leg." And he came up with this persona, Captain So and So. I can't think of the name. Captain So.
Captain Crunch.
No. That's something. I don't know.
All right. It's bird clock. We'll let the little bird sing. All right. So number 8. As part of her beauty regimen, Empress Elizabeth wore a mask made of melted cheese. Fish eggs, raw veal, or mayonnaise?
Mayonnaise.
I'm feeling.
Cheese.
Fish eggs.
I'm feeling like the cheesy. Fish eggs or the raw veal. People might think it's weird stuff.
I wonder if it might her complexion real creamy white.
I've used mayonnaise.
Does it work?
Yeah, it gets rid of the. Scaly skin.
You can use egg whites and put it with tissue paper.
We'll see, that's it in mayonnaise.
Yeah.
A lot of egg whites.
Yeah.
And it'll tighten your pores up.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, let's check.
Preparation H.
Raw veal.
First of all, veal is mean. I'd never eat veal.
There ain't no way I can do that.
No way.
Okay, so let's see.
I ain't asking either because I know the answer.
So this woman was apparently known as the Kate Middleton of yesteryear. Known for her exceptional beauty, she maintained a series of strange cosmetic practices. She washed her hair with eggs and brandy.
Woo!
I have seen where people use egg whites for their hair. I've seen
lemon foie. Those are two things that they can. Whoever makes it can take it and shove it. I don't care if it's the most delicious thing in the world. It's disgusting.
What they do to the animals.
You lock up cows, little baby calves in dark
rooms.
Okay, yeah, this is a Christmas show.
It's Christmas. We're not supposed to be
get on this subject. Oh, because of the veal mask.
Okay.
Anyhow.
We'll pass next.
So she washed her hair with eggs and brandy, and Applied face day. Masks made of crushed strawberries and raw veal. Okay, we got one more.
We should take a milk bath to fix it up.
Okay. Austria is home to the world's largest pine tree, glacier, freshwater lake, or ice cave.
Ice cave.
Freshwater lake.
I'll say ice cave.
Yeah.
Ice cave. It is cold over there. For real, it's cold. It is an ice cave.
Yay!
All right, so.
We win.
Okay, think back to the hottest day of the summer. It's real hot. Now, imagine that you could have stayed comfortably cool all day long without turning on the AC. Every year, 200,000 people do exactly that by delving deep into the chilly ice-risenwelt cave located inside the alpine Hochkollo mountain. The ice cave is the largest in the world by far. At just over 26 miles long, you could run a marathon inside of it.
You don't slip, bust your butt.
If you don't slip and slide, that's literally what it says.
Slide down a crevasse. And never be
no.
Yeah. Oh, your finny fell. Let's get to the foods. Alright, Kelly's chips. Kelly is a German name. Mom's a Kelly. Paprika chips. Between 1867 and 1918, Austria was part of Austria-Hungary, an empire where the two countries shared power and spices. So, Austria became hooked on paprika thanks to a man named Janos Kautsky. Yeah, I can't say that guy's name. That is not.
Okay, mama.
Yeah. Raised in something hungry, said Gid. Yeah, I dreamt of exploring the world to help save enough money to do so by selling paprika. He grew his own red peppers and dried them, processed his secret spicy sweet blend with his own milk. In 1887.
Oh my gosh.
Okay. Hey, I'll be there to play Skyrim in a second. What do you need? Okay. They don't sponsor us. It's okay. He likes Subway. Subway does not pay us. Yeah, just take my car.
Subway, you can pay us, though. And subs.
But, okay, now listen. If my car, where it's got the battery thing in it, you won't hear a starter come on. Yeah, so. Not ruin my car.
Don't get too many fusion.
Powered by the fusion core. No. I'm a beaten. Alright, anyway. Yeah, I'm about to be eaten. Okay, so. His paprika, the guy's paprika, went to Vienna and Austrians loved it. So they, modern day Austria paprika is considered country's most iconic blend, which is why I have to bring you these flavorful chips, bursting with that guy's sweet and spicy legacy. We hope you're very Austria hungry.
Austria-hungry?
We get to look at the
chips.
Austria-hungry? We get to look at the
chips, honey. Give them to her to pass them down.
Well, yeah, you should haul in a bigger one than that.
Okay, no. We'll give you the big one.
I'll give it to her. Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Here, I can't. I'm sorry.
Here, I'll take it. Ones? I don't care.
I'm just
taste testing.
Okay, let's taste.
Ooh.
Okay.
She likes it.
I'll eat it. Junebug likes it too.
Junebug says, yeah. You like it, Junju?
Well, see, visually, I looked at that and I thought, barbecue?
Barbecue, mm-hmm.
So my brain set up. So it took me a second.
It's not bad.
No, that's five.
It's not.
That's five space cats. Yeah. See, today we're on the space cat scale.
Five space cats.
Oh, so we're just doing space cats today.
I guess.
Pass another one so I can give Junebug.
We are on the space cat scale today. Unless Mama overrides it with a mama that she don't like it.
Okay. And Juju gives it five space cats.
We're gonna do space cats. Or mamas. Five mamas, four.
There you go, baby.
You'll understand.
In a minute when it kicks in.
Okay. Next.
Dog tested, dog approved.
Oh,
no, she, ooh, oh, she loves it.
She says five space cats.
Okay, look for this. So it is the Pichinger Mandel Regal. Almond cream filled wafer with milk chocolate and almond coating. So in the late 19th century, Austrian confectioner Oscar Pichinger created a plain round wafer that saw astronomical scales and launched his company to fame and earned the admiration of the royal court. While we love wafers as much as the next person, we were skeptical that a simple wafer really accomplished all that. The truth is that it did. Specifically, his main ingredient and extremely tasty cake, Oscar marketed his ordinary wafer for use as a special cake, Pichinger Torte, or Torte? I guess they would say it that way. Well, it's got an E at the end, and like, in German, you pronounce it Torte. Torte? I think.
Yeah.
Which quickly became the hottest recipe in Austria. But it's also Austrian German, so it might be different. To make it 12 wafers are slathered in rich chocolate spread. Ooh, placed on top of each other,
cool.
Then covered in a glue layer of melted chocolate. With this chocolate yum, you'll get a taste of the Pichinger. I'm gonna say torte. With a slight upgrade, delicious almond cream, crispy almond topping.
She's ready to try it.
I'm ready, but she can't have it.
That's mine.
I want to film part.
All these drinks are going to be the ones that visible. Yeah. Because we got lots of this here.
You ready? It smells good too, y'all.
It's
not my
part.
Cherry cordial.
It does.
I want another one.
It does taste like a chocolate covered cherry. That's crunchy. Mm-hmm.
My goodness.
Cordial cherries.
How much?
I do it.
Oh,
there's
10,000. 10,000.
Sorry,
Jasmine. Space cats.
Yes.
It's not
overly
sweet.
That's what I noticed about other countries.
Okay.
Not over sweet.
No, see that?
Yeah, we overdo it. Mm-hmm. Oh my lord.
It's good. It's good, but it's not like.
So, you notice anything funny about that bag?
They look like peanuts.
Yeah, they look like little peanuts.
No, it's got the American flag on it.
Oh, it sure does.
And it's from Austria. So, after World War II, American soldier Howard Morris Kelly decided to stay in Austria to start a snack company with his business partner Herbert Rost. Today, Kelly's is the top snack manufacturer in Austria, paying homage to their founder with these patriotic puffs. When do locals eat them? Given that snips are one of the country's top three snacks, the answer is simple, all the time. We're talking parties, holiday gatherings, movie nights, you name it. That got us extra excited for our next question. What do they taste like? Begin, you'll discover the unmistakably rich and savory flavors of salted peanuts.
Yeah.
You might even find yourself asking your own questions like, how did I eat these so fast?
Yes.
Yo.
I eat so fast, I'm not done. Showing them off. They look like, they're like Cheeto peanuts. Grabs,
just like pass back around grandma.
Yeah, they're like Cheeto peanuts.
Yeah, that's weird. Like that, I'm like
Cheeto nuts.
I kind of am weirded Jim out by it. One.
Yeah, Junebug says I has one. Like, okay. Junebug has one. Yeah, she's waiting on the sun.
Nope. I think it's dog approved.
Like a
Junebug. Yeah. Nuts. Ready.
That's pretty good.
That is good.
What do you think, Junebug?
Junebug like peanuts.
It's like Junebug. A Cheeto. Junebug. Like, I
dropped she dropped hers.
Uh oh.
I bet Junebug will find it for you.
Yeah, Junebug will find it.
Junebug will find it.
Mm-hmm. It's like peanut butter.
Yeah.
It's like crunchy peanut butter.
Mm-hmm. Very good.
I get 10 space cats. Oh. It gets 10.
10.
So, Junebug Plunkers.
Okay.
Hi, Google Honkers. We miss you. We love you.
Thank you.
I wonder how married life's doing. They haven't done a vlog in a while.
Oh,
I say that they're
they might be busy.
They're busy.
Okay. So the next things are Milch Waffles. Oh. Which strawberry cream filled wafer with chocolate. Waffles. Pop quiz. In Austria, ananas is the word for particular fruits. You can guess which. It's not bananas. Actually, it refers to pineapple and strawberry. Let us explain. Let's see. Austria in the early 20th century had tons of wild and farm strawberries called Erdbeeren, but barely any pineapples called ananas. Seeking to differentiate the strawberry varieties, Austria decided to call wild ones Erdbeeren and the farm ones ananas. Repurposing the unused word for pineapples.
Oh, yeah.
No, there's two of these.
Yeah, that's two.
Oh, okay. I was going to pass two.
All right. Until the 19th, let's see. In the 1970s, oh my gosh, I'm still reading. Austrian strawberry forests.
No, it is a big number.
Okay. Importing pineapples from the U.S., they repurposed the name ananas and had to come up with a new name for the fruit, so they sell them on Hawaii ananas. That's how you then pronounce Hawaii's Hawaii. To recap, Austrians refer to strawberries by their ananas or Erdbeeren. So you can use both to describe the creamy filling inside, crispy chocolatey wafer. We think you'll end up using delicious. Those look like them,
Watch, because they're crumbled.
What's some crunchy wafer things?
More? I want some more.
What's some crunchy wafer things that we have here?
All of them. 10 space cats with
thousands. Space cats. Yeah, I can't think of them. Yeah.
But they're like that long, yeah. And they're the pink or the middle. It kind of tasted like that, yeah. But this was
better.
They got
it tastes like natural strawberry flavoring instead of
chemicals.
Yeah.
Oh, God. We're into chemicals.
Really?
There's one in here called Bobby.
Bobby
caramel bar.
Bobby caramel bar.
Oh,
you gonna cut Bobby up?
Bobby. Welcome, Bobby. Bobby to the show.
He's gonna cut Bobby up. Oh, Bobby. We miss you, man. It was a short time to know you, Bobby. Bobby.
All right. So meet Count Bobby. That's the name of the dapper fella on his candy's wrapper. The subject of Austria's favorite jokes. No one knows who first came up with Count Bobby jokes, but they likely arose in the early 20th century as a way of poking fun at Austrian elites.
Is it like, hey, mama? Hey, mama jokes.
Yo, mama.
Yo, mama jokes. Hey, Bobby jokes.
Hold on.
Bobby
it's about
so
to
dumb.
Explain.
How dumb is Bobby?
Hold on.
He's
the jokes.
On the
hold on a second.
Quiet, let her read.
It's going to explain Bobby. If you. Okay, the jokes.
Bobby?
The jokes center on Count Bobby, a bumbling aristocrat who's always missing the point. So, how dumb is Bobby? I guess that counts.
That's like Mr. Magoo.
Take America. This one, for example. Hold on. Here's an actual joke. Count Bobby reads that in Munich, a pedestrian is struck by a car every hour. Shocked, he explains, that poor pedestrian. Jokes such as these have kept Austrians laughing for decades. By the 1950s, Count Bobby had become a household name, inspiring lengthy joke books, films starring Austrian actor Peter Alexander. I have heard of that name.
Hey,
and
boy.
Even this very chocolate bar, the Bobby Bar, premiered in 67, quickly becoming as ironic as its comedic namesake. With its rich milk, chocolate, crunchy rice crispies, soft caramel filling, this sweet doesn't have us laughing, it has us drilling.
Give me the small one.
Okay, I'll have
we all need t-shirts that says, hey, mommy!
That's your mama's.
Count Bobby!
You're supposed to read it with an Austrian accent.
Count Bobby reads,
Count Bobby.
In Munich of the town, a pedestrian is struck by a car every hour.
Struck by a car every hour?
Shocked,
read it like you're supposed to read it.
Shocked, he exclaims, that poor pedestrian.
Here, hell.
I don't get the joke. Am I dumb?
That poor pedestrian one.
That
same one.
See, you're supposed to read it like this.
Hold on, am I not reading?
Count Bobby reads Is that the mule pedestrians is struck now. By car Thank every you. Hour.
Somebody's a man landed.
He have kept Austrians laughing for that. Oh, oh.
You're not
the
taking
the typing so small. Sheila. Okay. Anyhow, I'm sorry. I digress. Yeah, I don't want
you're, to. Sheila, you know, I've been so decades. Since the 1950s.
Since the 1950s?
I can't
you
do it.
You don't say.
I can't do
Bobby,
it.
Bobby, you're such an idiot.
Let's try Bobby.
It's a dunk cup.
Dunk cup. It's a dunk cup.
Look at Bobby. Pass the tea. Pass the tongue. Here it comes.
Bobby's good.
Mommy, I real good.
Bobby tastes delicious. It is good.
That is familiar.
Mm-hmm.
See, it's the same thing.
You
the
don't like it?
The chocolate's not. Really?
Uh-oh. You don't like,
you don't like caramel?
I kind of like it, but I kind
of. I bet it's the caramel. You don't like that much, do you?
Kind of
like
a little bit. Kind of go.
Let it sink in.
Mm. Now, kids.
Oh, no.
No, when I stayed
in the space,
now it's 10.
Huh?
She likes it.
Oh, now it's 10? Okay.
I think
Bobby
the aftertaste is good.
Bobby was sweating there for a minute. What's the little girl going to think of
poor
me?
Bobby.
She does not like me. What's the
little girl?
Poor Bobby.
Oh, she likes me.
We are friends now. Bobby.
Oh, good. So good.
Hey, Bobby.
So if you want to say that tastes good in German, you say... das schmeckt mir gut. That tastes good to me.
Gut.
Das schmeckt mir gut.
Das schmeckt mir gut. I would say yum. Yeah. In Southern. Yum.
Okay, Custard gingerbread.
Custard. Oh, that must be this thing.
Ah, soft gingerbread with hazelnuts, almonds, candied orange, and sugar glaze.
It's just a generic
couch. So, also, apparently, Yum's has a holiday box.
Give June bugs some more of those that she could eat, you know, one at a time.
Because she
know.
Feels left out. Boom, boom.
Don't give her the massive ones. Like, save them for us.
Yeah, that's right. Don't get them all.
All right. So, our shoes eat gingerbread all year round. Their soft, round gingerbread cookies can have,
they're
like,
good,
honey. What is that word?
No, she can't have one of them because it's got nuts in it.
I don't know what that word is. Anise?
Honey, anise.
Anise? I don't know what that is.
It's that funny looking mess. It's what gives licorice that licorice taste.
I don't like licorice. Ugh.
What are they? They look like a little star.
Oh, star fruit?
No.
Okay.
Star anise. Yeah, that's what gives licorice taste.
Okay, we're convinced Austria has it right. The season of gingerbread should never end. They eat it like midday snack and dessert. There's really no bad time for them to eat gingerbread. I do like
it. You can't catch me.
I love little gingerbread man and Shrek.
That's my favorite cute.
I love
Don't catch your mind.
Don't get it.
Don't catch your mind. We don't want no blood in that.
It's weird. It's gingerbread. It's got like a sugar frosting.
I'll get my hand out of the shot. So I'm like,
no, actually, this new Apple music seems to, the focus seems to be looking a lot better.
Hey, you're back!
Sponsored by Subway!
We're eating some gingerbread. We might have an extra piece if you want one. Yeah, hold on a second. 2, 4, 6, 8.
How many tickets did you get her on her car?
He's got to come in here.
Yeah, you have to come in here and show your face.
Or you can show your back, your muscles.
You're the mystery man because
yeah, nobody
everybody knows.
Knows
y'all are engaged, but they don't know who you are.
You have to know, come around.
Behind her.
Yeah. And introduce who Honey Bunch is. This is Daniel.
That's Daniel.
Hi,
Daniel.
That's her Honey Bun.
That's my Honey Bun.
That's a honey.
Her
sweetie pie.
Okay, do you want a big piece? Do you want a big piece? Do you like gingerbread?
No, I want a piece.
I want a small piece.
Give Daniel a big piece.
I'll give you this massive piece.
Probably tastes awful.
No, it, no, don't eat it yet. Don't eat it yet. We have to eat it at the same time.
It's a group.
Yeah. It's a group effort. Right.
It's like we're doing communion.
It tastes like communion.
Hello. All right, ready?
Where's mine?
Where's your piece?
Where did
you
go?
Yeah, where is my piece?
Oh, maybe we need to split that up here.
No, here, you take that.
Well,
no,
nah, it's fine. Here, you got a bigger piece. It's fine. All right. We're good. All right. We're good.
I didn't want to take yours.
It's okay.
All right.
Oops. Okay.
Ready?
Ooh.
Ooh.
Tastes like a cross between a fruitcake and gingerbread.
Yeah.
That's odd.
Yeah.
It's good, but it's odd. Time for lunch.
It's got an
apple.
We don't want your opinion.
I thought it tasted like gingerbread.
Way to go, Daniel.
That's so odd. That's good.
It's got when you first put it in your mouth, it's got a certain taste. Like then citrus. There's another taste.
Mm-hmm. I'm tasting more of the gingerbread right now.
Gingerbread and like.
It's like a
orange,
fruitcake.
Yeah, it's kind of an orange.
Yeah, it said there's orange in it.
Yeah.
Hold on, let me read you this.
It's good.
Yeah, I know.
Let me read
the
things.
It's the perfect blend. It just kind of.
Hold on, it says that there's hazelnut, almond, candied orange, and sugar glaze.
Yeah.
So.
I rated it a four.
Four?
Four.
Oh, you didn't like it?
See
it. Come on. Can we squeeze this one more space, Kat? Give it five space.
She's been honest. She don't.
It's Christmas.
She's been honest.
She's 10 5.
10? Ah, we'll give it 5.
Is it 5 out of 5 or 5 out of 10?
5 out of 5.
Okay.
But I did these 10 space cats for the other ones, and she was like, eh. Okay.
All right. I think we got,
it's okay.
Wait,
it's
more.
Okay.
Did we eat the big banana?
I don't like that.
I skipped the big banana, so let's eat the big banana.
No, I don't
big
need
banana.
But another thing is all of these, they're not over the top banana sweet. Balls. They're just the right amount of sweet.
Mm-hmm. Do I got to sign some kind of paperwork?
Yeah, non-disclosure. <way out. laughs> Receptionist, she's got some legal documents at the front.
Yes.
All right, so the big banana. Dark chocolate big bar with banana mousse filling.
Ooh. Banana mousse.
So, is the, with the snow-capped Alps covering over 60% of Austria's land, the country isn't exactly equipped to grow tropical bananas. Nevertheless, they're Austria's second most popular fruit right behind apples.
But they're expensive, apples and bananas.
To satisfy local demand, 107,229 tons of bananas are imported from the Dominican Republic every year. The fruits are distributed to supermarkets.
It's shaped like a banana.
Is it?
Yeah, it's shaped like a banana.
A banana that went bad.
From there, fruits are, let's see.
Woo, it's banana.
They're transformed into
real
banana, countries.
Fake banana.
Most iconic treats, the choco banana, as in the chocolate banana. Readily available at convenience stores countrywide, these dark chocolate-coated banana mousse sweets, the most popular and delicious way the locals chow down on their favorite fruit. We predict you'll do just as the Austrians do when you try it, to go bananas. I'm excited.
It looks like real banana in there. Is it, Reckon?
It's got
banana mousse.
Banana mousse.
Banana.
Okay.
All right.
Give you those out.
Pass out the bananas.
I think the banana part's been shipping or something. Kind of seeped out.
You gotta have that, out. Baby girl.
Oh my goodness, that stinks.
No, you're smelling the dark chocolate, I think.
Yeah. Really? You gotta eat it.
Oh God, I'm with you. It stinks.
Won't smell it either. Okay, that one's a little.
This one's strange. I mean, I like it though. Because it's like a tarty banana flavor.
Yeah.
I can't eat it. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, Austria. You blew that one. Oh.
No,
it's not
that was
fake banana, it's a real banana.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a sour banana.
If I say
banana
so.
Yeah, but it
that shit doesn't taste so bad.
Grandma, give me that one if you don't want it. I'll eat it.
Yeah, I ain't giving mine to nobody but the trash can.
No.
Yeah, but did you put it in your mouth?
Zero.
Yeah.
Oh.
Zero. Never mind. Space cats.
Zero wow. For me, too.
Oh, I give it like at least two.
Bring it back because, yeah, it's four rangers.
At least four.
With me and her, it's four rangers.
Yeah.
Zero, one.
Zero space cats.
Zero.
No space
zero.
Cats.
Zero.
Y'all are right.
So it's one of those things that
it's an acquired taste.
It's an acquired
individual taste thing.
Mine is five.
And y'all can have that other one.
What?
That's disgusting.
There's another banana in there.
No, I just put it in there.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
My bad.
I mean, I would eat the whole thing.
I would. I mean, it's good, but it's different.
It's different.
Really different.
Did you wear those down? They got that on us.
That must be nut joke.
Yeah, nut joke. Hasselnuss vodka. Hazelnut chocolate cream filled wafer. Okay.
I know something. Austria is really into the
wafer. Just give me a taste of them.
That's true. There have been a lot of wafer vodka. Hey, y'all, I'm trying to read this. Hey, I'm trying to read this. What? Thanks. Life is sweeter in Vienna, at least according to the world-famous Mercer Quality of Living Survey. For 10 years straight, this extensive report has ranked Vienna the number one city in the world for its quality of life. In addition to receiving perfect scores for healthcare, education, and infrastructure, the city is also a bustling cultural hub, home to incredible art museums and iconic music venues like the Vienna State Opera. And it has an unbeatable cuisine. Look no further than the yum in your hand. This mouth-watering chocolate hazelnut wafer was invented in Vienna in 1898 and has since become a local specialty. Y'all quit fussing with that banana. It's done being done, y'all.
Get over the banana.
Get over the banana.
Get over it.
It has since become a local specialty. This crispy version topped with chopped hazelnuts, rich chocolate, you can taste for yourself what makes life so sweet.
You need another napkin now?
Arnold Schwarzenegger's from Austria.
Fantastic.
I can't believe they didn't have a little jar of Vienna sausage.
Here's what we think about the banana.
But there's only six of them.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, the 7th one is true love.
Yeah,
true love. What are you all talking about? Bug. Whoops. Okay, this one fell apart. Sorry.
I can't get a smell in this place.
The texture is. No, it's got chocolate.
Bad.
Here.
Give
her a peanut.
And Ajumba likes the peanuts.
It's Christmas.
Alright, you ready?
Ready.
Whoa. Better than that banana. Mm-hmm.
A lot better.
Chicken. Jimbo liked it.
Jimbo likes the peanuts.
Jimbo loves that peanut.
Is it cool, Mama?
I read it again.
No. It gets 5 rangers since it's 1 out of 5.
Well, that's the only thing I
it gets 10 space cats. So I guess the space cat's on a different scale.
No, because she wants 10 space cats. I'll give her 10 space cats. 5 rangers.
How many you got to go?
That's it.
Yeah, that's it.
So.
I'm just looking at the famous Austrian people. Nikola Tesla was from there.
Oh, yeah.
Stephen Freud, Marie Antoinette, Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, Gustav Klimt, Gregor Mendel, the guy that created, that came up with the genes thing. He discovered it, I reckon. And Wolfgang Puck.
Oh, God.
I'm gonna get
the
taste
up
now.
Okay. Now.
Oh, we get some pop now.
Soda pop.
Did you eat yours?
This is Coca-Cola made in Mexico.
Mexico.
Yeah,
are y'all done still talking about bananas? Get over yourselves.
No, we're getting on with the banana.
Wait, the hell it's made in Mexico is because it says
Mexico.
Refresco. What it is they have this factory in Mexico that makes Coca-Cola products. They still use sugar.
like the real,
yeah, the
real deal.
So we're gonna have a little taste test. You've already had that.
Do they, do I distribute the cups? Do I distribute the cups?
No, just three cups. All little each cup. We drink it all that way and we won't waste cups.
It ain't one, is it?
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, that's good.
It does. Tastes like cookies.
Yeah.
I want the last drop.
Do you remember when they changed the Coke recipe? That was a real thing.
You want another set of these? Or because, yeah, that would kind of contaminate. Run over
here.
Oh, Lord. Here, I'm watching. So what's going on next? So what do y'all
think
of that?
It's good.
It tastes like Coke used to taste like.
Yeah.
Okay.
So,
here's
mine. Five space cats?
Yep.
Ten.
Yeah. It's a pretty good product.
Okay. Which one?
Thank you, Mexico.
Subscribe.
Just
subscribe. We'll just go down the line.
Sprite refresco.
Yeah, I dropped the box and all. Hit myself in the face with the box.
Because I feel exactly know why it was the nutritional effects on the bottom. Must be some kind.
Donald Harvey go thud in the living room and it's like,
what's wrong?
Oh, you feel like the living
room? I fell. Stop. I've tripped over his foot massage. Yes. The big thing.
I'd say to take it to you when I was carrying it. It might not be required.
Basketball.
You put some kind of a catalyst.
That banana.
There'll be parties for hosting,
marshmallows for roasting, and caroling out in the snow.
That is different than the Sprite.
I'm good.
It doesn't have that harsh. It's nice, sweet.
Ooh, it's sweet. Yeah.
It's a lot smoother. The Sprite up here will like.
It'll open your eyeballs, make
them vomit. Okay, I don't think we need another cup for this.
No, because it's citrusy.
Yeah.
So all right, give me your cups. Okay, so.
Five Rangers and how much space cats?
Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to go down in a circle. It's Grandma's, Holland's. No, hold on a second. This is Holland's. Turtle. This was this
until one's. We plan this out really good.
We always do.
You want to just do new ones?
You're going to waste all Mama's cups.
I don't care. I have it.
You're going to waste Mama's.
We might as well use new ones.
All right.
We're just throwing them. I'm going to use the Mama's. Why? Because why?
It's her favorite cup, ain't
she's
it?
She's got something in her.
She got a special banana.
It's the most wonderful time. In case y'all are wondering why things are jittery, I'm just texting this because it's too long.
This is
my friend.
That's all. Yeah, mine's
up mine. 3, 4, 5, okay.
Can y'all sign one this year?
I'm sure.
That'd be a good sign.
Yeah, save yours to last.
Perfect.
Ready?
Okay.
Cheers.
Salute.
Mmm. That's good.
That is good.
Oh, that's really good.
It's smooth.
Mm-hmm. I think it's better than ours.
It really it's got more orange. Of a natural orange. Yeah.
It's more
as much sugar.
No, they don't. That's really good.
Well, let's read the sugar content.
Phew. How many calories?
Oh, sneeze.
Hold on a second. I'm at 160. No fat. Bless you.
Bless you.
42 grams of sugar. I don't know how many is actually like usually in a
child. 220.
The parrot was the, I got some Coke over here.
I think it's 200.
Yeah, go get you the bottle of Coke.
It's either 200.
My elbow or whatever.
Some.
I'm not good at food anymore.
It's okay.
It's all good.
It's all good.
What's
all right.
The calories and hours?
Okay.
210?
Yeah, that citrus has got my nose going.
Okay, 140. 140. This, the calories in this are 150, so there is more.
Yeah, a different size.
Total sugars are 39 grams. Different. This is 39 grams.
Yeah, but see, that's sugar and that's corn syrup.
This has 45 milligrams of sodium. This has 85. So that may be why that we're not tasting as much sugar because there's more salt to counteract it.
It's good.
It's good though. Yeah. So really, it's more unhealthy, but it does taste good.
Yes.
So, I guess we're done with that. Yeah. Hope everybody's stuck to the end.
Hope so.
This is going to be almost an hour long, but
we
I think
fun.
It's been cool.
We have fun.
So, everybody that's out there watching, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Hope y'all eat too much, get all your presents you wanted. Naughty people, take a cold.
Yeah.
Be humble. And try harder next year.
I've earned my cold.
There you go. God bless everybody.
God bless.
Say anything else? Or
we love all of y'all.
Yeah.
Merry Christmas.
Happy New Year.
Merry Christmas and Happy New Year 2020. I can't believe it.
Yay.
Huh? We're going to sing.
Wish you a Merry Christmas.
If you want. Well, if you're gonna sing.
Well, y'all gotta sing too now. Come on now.
Me.
Don't have me the only one.
All right, ready?
Mm-hmm. All right. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Good tidings.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas.
We love you all.
We love all of you. We'll see you on the next one.
You never know how a song is going to end with us singing it.
That was good.
Good sing. There we go. Jingle all the way. All the crowd is surrounded, one horse open sleigh. Hey! Jingle bells, jingle all the way. All the crowd is surrounded, one horse open sleigh. Hey! Dashing through the snow, and one horse open sleigh. Oh, the fields we go, laughing all the way. Ha ha ha! Making spirits bright, come on.
We have made you laugh, smile, and just enjoy our craziness.
That's right.
But most of all, we love y'all.
Love everybody.
Merry Christmas.
God bless everybody.
Or whatever holiday you serve.
That's right. Whatever holiday you celebrate.
Weihnachten.
This is a Christian holiday.
Happy Hanukkah.
Whatever they are, because there's apparently like 14 Kwanzaa, different ones.
Happy holidays, whichever holiday.
So,
and see y'all later. This time we're going to end it for sure.
And P.S. Don't tell us we suck as singers. We know we suck.
We know. That's okay.
Be kind with the comments.
That's right. Remember, follow Wawa. Remember that cold.
That's right.
Yeah, y'all nasty commenters getting that cold.
Nasty commenters that's starting the year off bad.
Yes.
Santa Claus.
And we will remember
and Krampus
too.
Krampus.
Whoops, I'm not baby.
Krampus.
Speaking of Krampus, you ought to see my character in Fallout 76.
I think I saw a picture of
it. Yeah, I posted it on my Facebook wall.
And I didn't understand. I was like,
well, it's a sheep squatch head, but it's a Santa Claus outfit. Sam Squatch. So it's like
it's Krampus.
Yeah.
It's Krampus.
Krampus.
So anyhow.
Believe in Jesus, for he is real.
That's right.
Yes.
I'll put a picture of that picture on here so
people
can see what I'm talking about. They're like,
okay,
what are you talking
God
about?
God bless everybody, and we hope you've been blessed or even got a chuckle out of us.
And not eating Bobby.
Yeah, and for eating Bobby.
Bobby.
And we
We're sorry, Bobby.
Sorry, Bobby. We ate
not
you.
Not sorry.
We didn't like your bananas.
Bobby was good.
But we
ate the bananas.
The bananas was different. I don't like them.
Not me.
Okay. All right. Bye.
See y'all.
We made it this time.
We love y'all. This time. Bye.
Bye. Come back and see us.